Amen. You ought to be excited. I'm thankful that God is in control. And keep that on the screen for me, that scripture, please. Thank you so much. On November 8th, 2016, what many are calling the inevitable happened. Donald Trump was elected the 45th president of the United States of America. What would follow is what I call mixed emotions. Of course, many are celebrating. In fact, where I'm from, a big town called Callahan, they had boots on, tight jeans, no shirts, rebel flags, and everybody was running and excited as if the country had changed. Many were shocked. Many were saddened. Many were disappointed. And you can't help but be disappointed when only 12% of the African Americans voted. That's disappointing. Many fear that what he will do when he's sworn in the office. And y'all, many things came to the forefront this week. Like, number one, racism is still alive. Number two, we have some people that don't care about feminism. Because how could we elect a man that degraded women to this? And yet it's women that helped put him in office. So with the black and Latino turnout being low, we essentially put him in office. It says that we don't care. And so since he's now in office, we are subject to being in authority under him. As his administration takes shape, thousands have taken to the streets. On Saturday, there were riots and uproars. From New York to Los Angeles, demonstrations have gone on for four nights now. Since his victory, there have been protests, which have included blocked bridges and highways, arrests, and a man shot yesterday in Portland, Oregon. In Los Angeles, MacArthur Park, the site of immigration rights protests, demonstrators took turns Saturday swatting a stick of a panther resembling Donald Trump. In New York, angry crowds carrying signs with messages that said, "Not my president," marched to Trump Tower, where Trump lives. For the march, they chanted, "Donald Trump, go away. Racist, sexist, and anti-gay." Now, I believe by your presence today at FMBC, we are saying that Christians, the Church of Jesus Christ, never panics because of who is the president. Why can I say that this morning? Because one thing I know, presidents come. And presidents go, but God stays the same. That's the shout today. Presidents have changed from Georgia. He's in office. We are subject to be under his authority. Let me give you some scripture. I know you say I ain't feeling that, Pastor. But 1 Peter 2:13 says, submit yourselves for the Lord's sake. Watch this. I ain't making it up. To every human institution. Whether to a king as the one authority or to governors or sent by him. Titus 3:1 says, remind them to subject to rulers, to authorities, to be obedient, to be ready for every good deed. And finally, our text today, you read it, says, let every soul be subject unto the higher powers. For there is no power but God. The powers that be are ordained of God. Y'all got a problem with that? That literally means that God allowed Donald Trump to win the election. Y'all can't handle it. Why would God? Won't be able to do what he said.